Hey YouTube, sorry for the late post. I know it's been like about 3 weeks since I last talked to you guys, and last time I talked to you I said that I was about, I want to say like 3-4 days late on my period. Well, I took multiple pregnancy tests and they were all negative. I took multiple blood tests and they were all negative. And so I started doing research on like HCG levels when you're pregnant, and so I read that some women, they don't have an HCG level because of their PCOS or something like that. I had people on the pages that I am following telling me like, oh, that doesn't make sense, that doesn't actually happen, that's all fake. And then I have other places where they're like, yeah, that's happened to me. I was 6 months pregnant and I didn't realize it because I never got a positive pregnancy test or blood test. And so it's like it gave me hope, but at the same time in the back of my head I was like, I'm probably not, but it's more so I want to make sure that I get help. Well, not help, but get the right, well, I guess you can say just stuff I need if I am pregnant. So, went to the doctor, told the doctor about what was going on. I was going to get an ultrasound, but I had to, basically if it was a longer time, that would end up being 25 days late for my period. And if it was going to be a little longer, then they would have done the ultrasound, but they didn't do one. I got my cycle last week. Yes, last week, the 19th, I got my period. I was very upset, but I guess I was stressed out and didn't realize I was stressed out because my period's never late. It's always on time. So I swore I was pregnant. Like, and I started getting headaches. I had headaches all that week and I had cravings, and it's like, it could have just been like my normal PMS cravings, but I ate like 10 oatmeal raisin cookies in one sitting, and it's like, I don't even eat oatmeal raisin cookies like that. Well, I love oatmeal raisin cookies, but I don't eat them all in one sitting. I try and stretch them out. So it's like, that was very interesting. So I didn't record anything because I thought I was pregnant and I didn't want to say, I'm pretty sure I'm pregnant, you guys, and then not actually have a pregnancy test on there for you. But so, after I did that, got my cycle, and then this weekend, we went to Disneyland. So I didn't record anything yesterday or what. It was just the girls' trip. Tim stayed home. He actually got me a little stand for wine and everything and put it in the corner, hung some stuff up. And I'll actually post a picture of that on Instagram later. I gotta fix it up. Pretty much the light is like glaring on our wedding invitation that we had framed. And yeah, I don't like the way it looks. So I'm gonna fix the picture and the light. And then I'm gonna take another picture and post it on Instagram. But besides that, nothing else. I'm currently now off my cycle, so that past cycle, it was 56 days long. That's like a record for me, and I don't like it. But now I am currently on day 10. So I'm supposed to start ovulating sometime later this week. This is the first, so I'm gonna start checking for ovulation. I got all my ovulation strips, everything. If this cycle I don't get pregnant, then in July we are going to start treatment again, and we're gonna do like one or two rounds and then that's it. If I don't get pregnant off of those one or two rounds, then we are definitely going to foster. We just have to figure out how we're going to do so, because we live in a 2-bedroom apartment. If you foster a child over the age of 2, they have to have their own bedroom. Which Angie's living with us, so that makes it a little harder. If we foster a child under the age of 2, they can sleep in our room. And I didn't want to have to put like an age limit on it after thinking about it for a while, but I think we are going to go for under 2, so the child can sleep in our room. And then that way, if we do end up adopting, it's like we're adopting them from a younger age. And yeah, it's either way, we wanted to adopt like a baby. I know people are like, oh, well, you need to adopt like a child. There's children that aren't getting adopted. It's like, yes, I understand that. But right now, we want to adopt a baby. And then later on, if we decide we want to adopt again, which we probably will, it will probably be a child. So yeah, but that's pretty much it. I'm not pregnant. I'm going to start trying to post a video every week. If I don't, it's going to be every other week or every 2 weeks. So I apologize now. But anyway, thank you for all the people who started following me. I really appreciate it. Thank you for commenting on my videos. If you guys have any questions to ask me, please leave them in the comments. And yeah, hit that like button. So I will catch you guys another time. See you later. Bye.